Well, a little rain never hurt anybody.
Yeah, but a lot can kill you.
What do we do now?
We get to higher ground!
Okay!
It's like something you would see in an action-adventure movie, such as this scene from Jumanji. A sudden gush of water, engulfing the ground and sweeping away everything in its path. But flash flooding isn't fiction, and here's why it could be coming to a city near you. Let's start with the basics. Flooding, when water overflows onto dry land, can be damaging whenever it occurs. But flash flooding can create an emergency in a very short time. There are two components that define a flash flood: volume of water and time. Basically, it's a flash flood when there is a lot of water, which moves into an area quickly. Often, it's caused by heavy rainfall over a period of less than 6 hours. Flash floods aren't always caused by heavy rain. They can also occur when structures like levees and dams fail. When any of these scenarios occur, we end up with a lot of excess water. All this excess water, called runoff, overwhelms natural water collection resources like rivers, lakes, and soil. It can also overwhelm human-made collection sites like sewers and reservoirs, since buildings and pavement can't absorb water. That's when we get water filling up streets, parks, and basements. The immediate, fast flow of water can injure or drown people, cause property damage, and contaminate water sources. But some areas are at more risk than others. A floodplain is a flat region close to a body of water that tends to flood. And 8 out of 10 Canadian cities are built on floodplains, according to a 2022 report by Public Safety Canada. Why would we do this? Well, the most common floodplains are near rivers or streams. This type of land is ideal farmland and handy for transportation, so many settlements end up being built on floodplains. Over time, those settlements expanded into the cities we have today. But today, climate change is making things worse. As air temperatures increase, the air can hold more moisture, which increases the amount of rain we get and how intense the storms will be. Plus, climate change is worsening other weather events, like atmospheric rivers and hurricanes, which can also trigger flash floods. One of the ways to limit flooding is to reintroduce absorbent soil in towns and cities. Montreal and Vancouver are doing this by building sponge parks that help soak up runoff water. For more about extreme events in nature, check out more videos on our YouTube channel or cbckidsnews.ca. For CBC Kids News, I'm Aerin Murphy.